When I think of Cabo Verdeans, probably two of the first things that come to my mind are happy and open. You could talk to anyone on the street. We had no problem at all contacting people. They would often say, "Yeah, come share the word of God with me," even if they weren't particularly interested. There were very few times that we were harshly rejected. People were always open to at least hear what our message was, and even if they didn't particularly want to, join the church or follow like what we believe, they're always very happy, very open, and they are just full of light. They're sweet, sweet people. The church has grown there so much because they've been prepared to receive the gospel, and they're really funny. They speak a Creole language, so they speak Portuguese, what they're taught in school, but then like their native language, they speak Creole, either Bedio or Sampajudo, and they joke around a lot in that language, and they always tell little funny anecdotes, and the Creole was really fun, and you always hear them yelling it at each other in the street because they communicate in a very loud way, and so it's a place that it's very different being back in the States, especially in Utah, where it's really quiet here, especially in the evenings and things like that. They're Coverdians, they do enjoy, a good party once in a while, and they're always, just happy. They do live hard lives in the sense that they really have to work just to have, food on their table. But I was always surprised by how happy they were, even though they live in such humble circumstances, and often difficult circumstances with their families and just kind of like the social and political things that are happening there. They're very happy and they're very optimistic, and they're really an example. I realized that we have so much here, and I could definitely be more grateful and more hopeful after kind of seeing their example. So the population in Cabo Verde was created when Portugal colonized those islands, and they used it as a slave trade route. And so the people there are a mix between Europeans and then Africans. And there are some Europeans there now. They usually come as like tourists, or they have businesses there. And there are people who come from West Africa still. But the Cabo Verdeans are definitely different from those two parties. They're very humble people, like I said, but they're very prideful in the fact that they are Cabo Verdean. I had many discussions with Cabo Verdeans that distinctly said they were not African and they were not European. They're Cabo Verdean. And so they have a lot of pride for their country. And they recently gained independence in 1975. And so they're a very young country. They've only been independent from Portugal for a short time. But they have an interesting demographic as well. Depending on which island you are, people can have a different appearance. Some islands people have lighter skin, some islands they have darker skin. You definitely see people with blue eye with hold on. You see a lot of Cabo Verdeans who can have green eyes or blue eyes. You can have blonde hair, you could have red hair, you could have black hair. They're a very colorful people. Which I was not expecting. I was always surprised at the diversity that there is, even though the islands are so small and have such a small population on them.
People are so ready to serve you or help you in like any way or give you things. Like there was one day, it was insane, but like it me and my companion called it free day, and everyone just like gave us stuff like all day. I don't know if it was like a holiday or something, but like we left the house with like just our normal stuff in our backpacks, and at the end of the day we had like 6 cobs of corn, we had like a shirt, we had like all these different little things that people had given us, like a head of lettuce. Like, it's so cool. The people are just so giving. They have so little, but they give so much. They're also just a beautiful people. Like, just like there's sometimes where I'm just like looking at them and I'm like, they are just so like, I don't know. It's maybe it's their mixed race and their mixed cultures that just make them really beautiful, and they're very diverse as well. So you find a lot of people that look like they're just straight African, and a lot of people that look like they're even European, like they have skin tone like me and blue eyes, but they're raised like anyone else, and it's just usually because they're closer to the Portuguese side, like they have a parent or a grandparent that's from Portugal. And the interesting thing is, there are sort of classes, and a lot of the time, the fairer you are, the more successful you tend to be. I don't know if that's because people treat you different, or you act differently, or you're just raised a different way, but that's something that's really interesting to get used to. And but the important thing is just to love everyone, because everyone is just so beautiful and so nice. And that's something I just really love about the culture, is they adopt you, and especially if you do your best to just relate with them, learn the language, learn the culture, and appreciate like their families, then they'll totally reciprocate without exception.